Welcome. My name is Darcy Ventura. I'm with the Nature Conservancy, and we're up on the Cle Elum Ridge today. In 2014, the Nature Conservancy formed a partnership and created an LLC to acquire about 10,000 acres up here on the Cle Elum Ridge. We pushed the pause button on the development threat to figure out what the best permanent solution for these lands looks like. This 10,000-acre parcel sits above the communities of Ronald, Roslyn, and Cle Elum, and the Tiyanaway Community Forest and the Alpine Lakes Wilderness is behind me. The primary goal of this project is to protect these lands, so we have turned this land into a living laboratory. Let's go check it out. First up, we look at what the forest needs to be more healthy.
My name's Kyle, and my job is to make these forests healthy. We like to say we have a tree problem. The issue we're dealing with is too many trees. For the last over 100 years, we've suppressed fire in these forests, and what it's caused is these forests to come in really dense. When a fire comes through, it'll go up into that small tree, up into the medium tree, and then the larger tree, and basically kill everything. My job is to do forest restoration up here, and we're trying different techniques. So we're using machine masticators, which are basically these industrial strength lawnmowers that chew up the fuels and the small trees on the forest floor. We have pre-commercial thinning, which is hand crews with chainsaws. And then we have commercial thinning, which is logging.
My name is Herman, and my job is to take the plans that Kyle and I come up with and implement them on the forest. I managed all our contractors being out there every day to give them a spacing, just an idea of how far apart we want trees. We're looking for large openings. We're looking for some clumps and clearing around single trees.
That's really our focus, is to do fuels reduction work and reduce the risk of catastrophic wildfire. This is basically like a living laboratory we're using up here. We get to try different things all the time and use science as our guide.
My name's Sammy, and my job is to utilize fire to make this landscape more healthy. Prescribed fire is a great tool to help reduce the fuels that are in the forest. You often hear the term fighting fire with fire. We decide when and where we go in and put fire on the ground. If then a wildfire does come through that area, it doesn't have any more fuel to consume. Fire is a natural part of the landscape, and so we're just using fire really to do what it has always done.
So thinning and prescribed fire do amazing work for forest health, but at the same time, they're creating jobs for our region and sustainable forest products. Most importantly, we're being good neighbors by reducing wildfire risk in these forests.
My name's Amy, and my family and I live in Roslyn. To see these forest health treatments go on in my backyard, it provides a level of reassurance that we're doing the best that we can with the available knowledge that we have to be able to provide protection if a wildfire were to come through again. As a mom and my family living here, I do feel safer with the treatments that they're doing and the work that's being done by the Nature Conservancy.
The stakes are really high here. The water from these lands feed a $5 billion annual agricultural economy downstream, along with supplying water for communities and salmon. So as we experimented with forest health treatments, we recognized an opportunity to research the relationship between tree canopy, snowpack retention, and water.
My name is Emily Howe, and my job is to connect the science to the work that we do on the ground. I'm interested in water outcomes. So how does the work that we do in the forest impact what's happening down in the rivers and streams? And so one of the things we're looking at here is, if we open up canopy gaps for fire resilience, what does that do to the snowpack? What we found is that we can get snowpack to last up to 30 days longer on north-facing slopes when we open up small canopy gaps. Water is fundamental to all forms of life. To find a new way forward in this kind of novel landscape, that is really inspiring, I think. We hope that projects like this will help us take care of the land in a way that supports all the species that depend on water, including ourselves.
We have the potential to take this innovation to scale and have an impact on water scarcity across the Western U.S. Our last stop brings us to a trail where we've been partnering with other organizations to create awesome pathways and networks through these forests that will remain open to the public forever.
My name's Nikki, and my job is to connect people with the outdoors.
The Cle Elum Ridge is right behind the three communities of Cle Elum, Roslyn, and Ronald. The thing about it is that there had never really been any official trails up here. So we're working with TNC and members of the community to design this really cool new trail system called Towns to Tianaway, in order to implement and build these trails. An intense wildfire season can completely wipe out a recreational season out here. So prescribed burning, planning ahead, making these forests more resilient to fire, that is instrumental in making sure that we don't have those years where there's just absolutely no recreation happening in Kittitas County.
Here at the Nature Conservancy, we like to innovate and push the envelope. And we believe wholeheartedly that if we try new ideas, learn from our mistakes, that we can save these forests. The landscape is healthier and our communities are safer as a result of this work. And I couldn't be prouder to be a part of that. And we've saved the best part for last. We're really excited about the opportunity to add these lands to the Tianaway Community Forest, protecting them for people forever.